So children, in the last class, we were discussing the topic called understanding elementary shapes. So which topic we have started? Yes, we have started with understanding elementary shapes. And in this, what all we have discussed, children? Yes, we have discussed firstly about the line segment. So what we have discussed, children?
Yes, we have discussed with the
line segment, and I hope you all know what do you mean by line segment. Means you all have understood the difference between the line segment, rays, and so on. So now line segment, which will be having fixed endpoints, and it is not going to extend further. So this is about the line segment. So to measure a line segment, we have studied three methods. So can you tell children which were those three methods?
Yes.
First method, measuring the line segment by observation. And second, it was by tracing method. And third, it was by using the divider and the ruler. So these were the three methods used to measure the lines. So line segment, not a line. Then after that, we have studied about the angles. Yes, so children?
Yes.
In that, we have studied the types of angles. Like, can you all say?
Yes.
We have studied about the right angle. Then, we have studied about the straight angle. Then, we have studied about the complete angle, acute angle, obtuse angle. Then, we have studied about the reflex angle. Okay. Now, in today's class, we are going to learn about the measuring of angles. So you all know, as I said, angles will be, acute angles will be less than 90 degree and obtuse angle will be more than 90 degree, less than 180 degree. So on you have studied. Now, how to measure the angles, we are going to study in the today's class. Okay. And one thing I want you to tell, and to measure the angles, we need one instrument. So which is that, children? Can you tell? To draw a circle, what do you need? Yes, you all know, you need compass. So, to draw a circle, you need a compass. Likewise, to measure the angles, we need an instrument called protractor. So, with the help of this protractor, you are going to measure the angles, children. So, those who have, please, you have to remove it outside and you have to do whatever I am doing. So those who don't have, take your time. You have to buy and you have to do it later. Okay. So now in today's class, we are going to learn how to measure the angles. So firstly, we will take one angle, children. So you can take any angle like 60 degrees. So I want to create an angle of 60 degrees. So how to do it, children?
Yes.
It's very simple. So in stepwise, I'll be telling you have to follow the same. So first step is what, children? To measure the or to create the angle, first you have to draw a line segment. So what you have to do? You have to draw a line segment. So this line segment, it will be not having an exact measurement. You should not take, once you have to use 6 cm, 7 cm, like this restriction will be not there in this. You can just draw a line segment. Second step is what? What is the second step? You need to make an angle of 60 degrees. So now you have to make an angle of 60 degrees. For that, you need the instrument like protractor. So as I shown you, this is the small one. If I use this, it will be not visible for you all, children. That's why I am using the big protractor. So I am going to explain with this. So first step, you have drawn the line segment. Second step is what? So you all know this is the line segment and this is the vertex point. So now you have to place this protractor on the vertex point. So now this will be the protractor vertex. So this point you have to place on this vertex. So and third step, you have to place whatever this protractor line is there, that line you have to place on the line segment. So whichever you have drawn, on that you have to place. So your vertices and protractor vertices should be means they should fall on each other. They should fall on each other and the line also should fall on each other. So, suppose if you place the vertex and if the lines does not fall on each other, then it is wrong way of measuring. So, if line is here and your protector line is here and you are pointing your vertices is here. If you do like this, it will be wrong channel. Please make sure that please try to understand how to measure it. So this point and this line should be same. Means like this. So now completely like this they should form. Now you have to measure the 60 degree. So to measure 60 degree, now you have to see the downside numbers. Don't get confused with the upside number. As you all know, each rectangle always falls this side. Yes or no? Here you all can see it is a 60 degree. So now you can mark one line here, then you can draw a line like this, right? You have to draw a line like this. So now it became an angle of 60 degree. So you can name them as A, B and C. So which angle it is given? Can you tell? 60 degree is an acute angle. In this way you need to measure. So let me take one more example. For same acute angle, like if you take 45 degree. Please try it, children. Try it. Okay. It's very simple. First you have to draw one line segment. So what you have to do? One straight line segment you should draw. If you draw like this cross line segment, then your measure will be wrong. Okay? Make sure that you have to draw one line segment using your scale. Take your scale, one line you have to draw. Means it will be not having specific centimeters, just one line segment you have to draw. Then second step, you have to place this protector like this in there. So please make sure that this point, vertices point and this vertex, they should match. So you have to place each other, then this line should follow each other. So in that way you have to arrange. So now you have to measure 45 degree. So you all can see children, here it is 40. So you all can see here it is 40, here it is 50. So in between whichever this bigger line is there, this will be the 45 degree line. So in between 40 and 50 you have to see 45. So 45, to see the 45 you have to see in between 40 and 50. And this 40 and 50, between 40 and 50, one you can see one big line. Remaining all lines you all can see smaller. Means it is considered as 41, this line 42, 43, 44 and this big line it will be 45. So there you have to mark. So now you have to mark here 45. Then like this you have to join the line. It's very simple, right? You can write it is a 45 degree angle, then you can name it as PQR. Okay. This is all about acute angle, how to measure the acute angle. Likewise, right angle. Yes, you know it's very simple, children. Right angle of, what is the measure of right angle?
Yes,
the measure of right angle is exactly 90 degree. Okay, so to measure the 90 degree, someone, now how you have to measure? Again, you have to draw one line. Again, children, you have to place this protector on this line segment. Yes, like this. Like this you have to place. Then you all in here, you all can see 90. Then like this you have to join the line. So now you all can see it is the 90 degree angle. Then you can name it as yes, PQ. It's very simple. Okay, this is 90 degree angle. And it looks like this. Okay. Then next shall we go to the obtuse angle, children?
Okay.
So you all know obtuse angle measures greater than 90 degree but less than 180 degree. So now let's just take 170 degree. So 170 degree is which angle? Yes, it is obtuse angle. Again for this. Same mark the place. Then what is the degree given here? 170. So you have to see the downside number. It is 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, this is 90. Then 100, 110, 120, 30, 140, 150, 160, 170. So it is way cheaper. It is here. Then after you have to draw a line like this. Next, it is an obtuse angle. So what degree they have given? They have given the 170 degrees. So it looks like this. And you know, obtuse angle always falls this side. Okay, acute angle will be this side. As I showed, and obtuse angle like this is going to fall. Acute angle are going to fall like this. Just for identification, I'm checking. Okay. Let us see one more example for the obtuse angle. So you can take any angle, any degree. So you can take any degree, but it should be more than 90 degree and it should be less than 180 degree. So now, fifth one, you can think it as like you can take 110 degrees. So now you can take and you can create an angle. So this is the line segment. Now we want to measure the 110. So likewise you have to place here children like this. Then we have to see the top side number. So where is 110? Yes, you all can see here. It is 110. So you have to mark here. Then like this you are going to join the line, and this angle formed is 110. Okay, then you can name the angle as you wish. So this is all about the measuring of the angles. So usually angles are made and measured using what, chickens? Yes, angles are measured using the instrument called protractor. So what, here we will be getting the different types of questions, right? Sometimes they give you the figure like this, and they ask you to measure this angle. So now at that time what you have to do, children, this one line you have to make it as base. So one line you have to make it as base, then you have to measure how much degree angle it is. Sometimes they give you the direct degree and you have to make the angles like this. So one type of the question is this. Another type is what, they will give you the figure. By this, you have to find how much degree angle it is. Okay? Shall we see it, children? Okay, they have given like this. Now, what you have to do? One line you have to make it as base, and here you have to place this protector, and you have to see where this line is falling. So, all you can see here, children, like this you have to see, and this line is falling on 45 degree. So, on this line, means the line is falling here, and you have to see how much degree it is. Then this is the 45 degree angle. Okay, sometimes they will give like this. Supposing you like this, if they give, then you need to measure how much degree it is. So it's very simple. You have to place the protector here, you have to place the protector like this, and you have to see this line is falling where. So you all, you can see this line. So this line, so neatly you have to place. This line is exactly on 130 degree. So this line, now it is falling exactly 130 degree. So it is in an angle of 130 degree. So you get two types of question in here. Sometimes very good degree, you have to create the angle. Second way, already they give you the figure, you have to find the how much degree angle it is. Okay? So this is all about the measuring of the angles. It's very simple. Please, at once you may not understand. See the video once, twice, thrice, even you'll get clear with this. Okay? And compulsorily you have to use this protector. Okay? Buy this and you have to do this. Okay? In the next class,